listening to The Sauce, recorded live in the FingerLakes1.com studios, deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York, featuring Bandy, R&D, Mysterious Taco Girl, Only Sometimes, and Saucy Joe. And now,
good evening, Saucepod streamers, wherever you might be tonight. It's a me, Tony Sometimes, and this is episode number 119 of the Sauce Podcast. Recorded live in the FingerLakes1.com studios, deep beneath historic downtown Seneca Falls, New York. It's Monday, September 30th, 2013, and tonight, in a special episode focused on women's issues, we'll be talking about if a woman needs it, should she be spanked? And are women damaging their ovaries by driving cars? One Saudi cleric says yes. What is arousing complaints in Scott Township, Pennsylvania? Our weekly recommendations, Tweet of the Week, Dandy's Choice, and much, much more. Per usual, I'm joined up here tonight by my saucy compañeros, Dandy Aaron D.
Good evening.
And Mysterious Taco Girl.
Hello there.
And feeling a little under the weather, but still in studio with us tonight, Saucy Joe.
Yeah, hello.
And, well, let's get right to it, guys. If a woman deserves it, should she be spanked?
Didn't we already talk about this?
No.
Yeah, we did. We talked about all the spanking from the old men. Remember?
Well, I don't know if you've seen the, this is actually going back a week or two. There was a internet meme making the rounds. And it was a old article from the, what was it called? The New York Mirror.
From New York City, right?
New York City, yes.
Yeah, we talked about this.
I don't think we did, Dandy.
I think maybe you talked about it with someone else.
No, we definitely did, because you saw all the people's names, and the one guy was like a factory worker, and he said spanking his wife was well worth it.
Well, Dandy, that's what I got planned for tonight, but believe me, this is the first time that we've talked about this or done this on the Sauce Pod.
We've talked about this before.
No, it must have been another podcast that you've listened to.
Why did your crotch just flash?
I guess I got a text. Can you turn my headphones on?
Sure.
So I can put them in.
I'd be glad to. How's that?
No change.
How's it that? It's better? Okay. So anyways, Daily Mirror penned an article called If a Woman Needs It, Should She Be Spanked? And this wasn't recent, though. This was like in the 1950s. There's the old article. And it's interesting to read what some of these gentlemen said and what they felt was good for publication back in the 1950s in the Daily Mirror in New York City. So first we got Miguel Matos. He's a counterman in Brooklyn.
Counterman.
Yep, he's a counterman. So Miguel Matos says, why not? If they don't know how to behave by the time they're adults, they should be treated like children and spanked. That ought to make them grow up in a hurry. If it doesn't at first, they'll soon get the idea. It's reasonable. And then we got this this gentleman named Frank
Grimy Grimes
Desiderio. Oh. He is a barber from Brooklyn. And he says, yes, when they deserve it. As a barber, I've got a lot of faith in the hairbrush. I think there are certain cases when it is advisable. And when it is, there's no reason why you shouldn't go right ahead and do it. I can't knock the idea. In my business, a man sets a lot of store by the results he can get with a hairbrush properly applied. He's talking about using a hairbrush to spank
a woman
who deserves it.
But he's also saying that he uses a hairbrush professionally.
Right.
So he places a lot of faith in that.
So far, we have two yays and no nays.
No nays, but both from men, interestingly. Two yays.
The third
have they asked any women?
The third entry in this article is from a gentleman named Teddy Glee.
Oh, he looks like an anti-spanker.
Yeah, look at this guy. He's a Brooklyn parking lot attendant, and he says, "You bet." It teaches them who's boss. A lot of women tend to forget this is a man's world, and a lot of men who step down as boss of a family wish they hadn't. Spanking might help get back some of the respect they lost.
So if you're feeling emasculated by your lady friend, time to spank and get back on top in the relationship.
According to Teddy. And then finally, we got one more entry in this article from a gentleman named William Davis. He is a Brooklyn toy factory owner.
Oh, he's an owner.
Yeah, this guy owns a toy factory.
I think he made that up by the looks of it.
And he makes an even 4 for 4. Yes, most of them have it coming to them anyways. If they don't, it will remind them how well off they are.
Wow.
I subscribe to the theory that an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure.
Ah.
What questions are burning around in your mind? Send it to You Said It, New York Mirror, 235 East 45th Street, New York. New York, for each query used, the mirror will pay $10. So these guys all made $10. Or no, the guy who asked the question.
And that was from a publication from 2010.
Recent. So, Mysterious Taco Girl.
Yeah.
What do you think? If a woman deserves it, should she be spanked?
Do you agree with all four of these men that were polled in 1950?
No.
You don't agree with their attitudes?
No.
Surprising. I am surprised.
Are you glad that you live in the year 2013 and in 1950? Because you're a bit romantic.
No, not necessarily so.
But back in those days, you could flat out be spanked at any moment. And, you know, they wouldn't even arrest the guy.
Yeah, but you don't really know any better.
Well, that's true.
There were simpler times. It was a man's world. It was said right in that. That guy said it's a man's world.
You know, you don't.
I mean,
you don't know what you could have. You don't know the freedom.
Right.
That you
also
have,
probably wouldn't be out doing the things you're doing, you know?
I wouldn't be here.
You wouldn't be here on a Monday night.
No, if you got caught doing a spot podcast, some man would spank you.
You'd be spanked.
Reprimand you.
Bottom was as red as a lobster.
That is for sure.
So, Dandy, how do you feel about this?
I still spank bitches.
Dandy still spanks bitches. Good. Good.
Well, this is generally like our grandmothers. This is these are the men that our grandmothers coexisted with.
Yep.
And, geez, I never saw any spanking going on when I was a kid.
No, but you've probably, I've certainly seen the attitude from people, older people.
I mean, today this is domestic violence and you could be arrested, but 60 years ago it was fodder for a legitimate question in a newspaper.
I think if my grandfather tried to spank my grandmother, he'd be walking away with a few less teeth.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that also depends on the couple.
What about you?
What about me?
I'm pretty sure your grandma would smack shit out of your grandpa, too.
Yep. You're right about that.
Who knows? We weren't there. We weren't behind closed doors when our grandmothers were misbehaved.
I don't know. I don't think my grandmother's ever misbehaved.
I was there as a child, and I was there for the go to the store and get that. You know, my grandma was like,
yeah,
hardcore. Yeah, she needed things, the errands done and chores completed,
and she got them done and completed.
My grandfather didn't say a word either. He just did it.
He just did it.
He knew better.
He knew where his bread was buttered.
He didn't want to get spanked,
right? Or did he?
He would have said no if he did.
So, Mysterious Taco, I'm a little surprised that you're not like, geez, you're like okay with this.
Well, so, she's thinking about it logically.
Well, she's in the views of a woman in that age, in that day, didn't know any better.
But as a modern woman, if, let's say you, all the things that go along with this, like all your rights, and you couldn't do this podcast, you couldn't do any of these things.
You couldn't twiddle around on that iPhone like you're doing.
You couldn't possibly be happy with that, knowing what you know now.
Knowing what I know now, no.
Having it taken away from you is one thing, right?
Yeah, that would be awful.
1 minute you're playing Candy Crush on your iPhone, the next minute you're getting spanked by
a toy shop
Frank Desiderio with a hairbrush.
Yeah, no, I mean, that would not be cool.
Well, you know, I figured with the National Women's Hall of Fame induction ceremony coming up in just 2 weeks.
Yeah, that was a good start to the special women's issues edition.
I mean, here's the thing. I'm also completely outnumbered here, so it's kind of like...
Well, we're not going to...
What, you think that we, like, are like, see, yeah, those were the days. Those were the days. I think it's kind of shocking, and I feel bad for all women born before, like, 1965, you know?
Yeah.
But they all seem... My grandma was a happy woman, I'd say.
She probably didn't know any better. That's what
she's saying. Or maybe she'd been spanked so much that it brought her right in line.
Right.
I mean, it's a dehumanizing thing to spank someone like that.
It's a little, yeah. Got to make yourself known as the alpha dog.
The other thing is, if things can change so much to a point where that could an article like that could be posted in a newspaper and there not be outrage, to today, think of how much things could change in 60 more years, not necessarily for the good.
Could be women who are doing the spanking.
Well, things could just go bad in our society. Go down a road. I mean, look at Nazi Germany. You know, that was a modern society that kind of took a turn for the worse pretty quickly. And now they got... There's something about... Germany copyright stuff internationally is pretty much all on the same page, but not Germany. They shut everything down. You can't even whistle Dixie in Germany without a copyright violation being slapped on your ass.
Did you see, who's that fucking stupid comedian that I don't like?
I don't know.
Carrot Top?
No, Russell something.
Russell Brand?
See the comment he made?
About?
He got something happened. He was in an award show, and Hugo Boss was one of the major sponsors. So he got on stage and said, just so everybody knows, Hugo Boss was the one who made Nazi Germany uniforms. And they asked him to leave.
Oh, wow.
I thought it was pretty funny.
He is a comedian.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't think... Somebody
that was on stage before him did something, like, political, so he got on stage and was like, all right, well, fuck you.
Right.
Well, Mysterious Tiger Girl's enjoying a beverage. Let's find out exactly what that might be.
Men drink
it's
like
a woman's
that.
Issue.
He is going to die.
We save hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast.
Bet, babe, slide a piece of the porter. Because I run the job.
Look at here.
What are you drinking, Serious Tiger Girl?
Beak and Skiff Farms apple cider.
Ooh, local apple cider from...
The label's not even on straight.
No, it isn't, but that just shows how organic it is.
Hugo Boss was a supplier of uniforms to the
it's
Nazi
legit?
Party. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Just so you know. Carry on.
So, how is it? Good cider?
Yeah. Fantastic.
What would, can you just take a quick gander at those ingredients? And I'm just wondering if there might be anything different from, like,
guess.
Mott's applesauce. Or apple juice or whatever. Who makes apple juice? Mott's? Yeah, Mott's makes apple juice.
Sure they do. It's like the number one thing they do is apples.
What's the sugar content in there? What's the number, top three ingredients?
That'd be water, apples,
and sugar,
corn syrup. No, they
There's
wouldn't use
30
plenty of sugar
grams
in apples.
Of sugar.
Oh yeah.
Guess you guys got to guess. The
apples,
ingredients.
I just water,
did water,
sugar.
Apples.
Top three.
And
Skiff
contains apple cider.
That's it, huh?
Yeah.
Just apple cider.
It's
so
just apple cider.
Just apples. Okay.
Pasteurized apple cider.
Well, right. The thing is, Beacon Skiff's a big apple farm out to our east in what's the name of the town? Lysander?
Lafayette.
Lafayette, yeah, I know, started with an L. And you'd think that if you buy that there, you're thinking that's fresh from the orchard and into the...
Yeah, I don't think they add anything. I think it's just pressed apples.
Oh, I'm implying that maybe they get that made by Mott's or somebody and throw a little Beacon Skiff label on there.
No, because it would say, like, packaged in blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but it doesn't say anything like that.
No, it's Beacon Skiff Cider Mill.
Did you go to Beacon Skiff Farms, like, obviously, this past weekend?
No, I went to the gas station.
They have that in the old gas station.
Oh, really?
Sure.
Oh, wow.
It's the season.
It is the season for going to apple farms. It's always the season for going to gas stations.
I drove by an apple farm yesterday, and it was no parking available.
Yeah, it was jam-packed, huh?
It's a new craze. I'm not a big fan, and I'm not...
Of apples or apple picking?
I like apples, but, yeah, apple picking. It's,
It's what we pay the Mexicans to do.
I agree.
We go to the grocery store, we get the apples and bring them home. We don't need to pick them off the tree.
You're taking away hard-working Mexican jobs by going out and picking your own apples.
Yeah, it's just kind of eliminating the middleman. But
they're not as good as apples as you get at a store, though.
Right. You think you're going to get these are fresh off the tree. They're going to be great, but they're, I don't know, they especially depending on when you go. Sometimes you don't even get the best pick of the apples.
Yeah.
But if I do go to an apple farm or some sort of thing like that, I like it if they have a complimentary shop where they make jellies and other things like that. That's kind of good. Hay rides are nice, I suppose.
I agree.
But I don't need to pick apples. Those are heavy.
Yeah, when if you pick a bushel.
Yeah.
It's a heavy. A bushel weighs a lot.
It's a good workout.
Yeah.
Well, they're not even going to fit in a bag. You're going to need a basket.
Other apple measurements are a peck. I don't know how many pecks are in a bushel. Or how many bushels are in a peck. I'm going to find out right now.
You got it?
Yeah, I got this. I got this. Pecks per bushel. Survey says. There's 4 U.S. pecks in 1 U.S. bushel.
Oh, so these are standardized internationally as well. Like a UK peck is different than a US peck.
I guess so. 4 pecks is 8 gallons, so I'm guessing a peck is 2 gallons. If you're using it liquid wise.
I don't think it's a liquid form of measurement.
It can be.
Hmm. Well, Dandy Aaron D, what are you drinking?
Stewart's Black Cherry Fountain Classics.
You like that? You drink that a lot?
Stewart's. It's not something I'm going to buy again.
I try not to stray from the root beer or the cream soda. I mean,
I've had all those, so I decided to give the Black Cherry one. I mean, it's not bad, but it punches you right in the throat.
That's Stewart's for you.
Sometimes you see something like that, whether it's a beverage or usually a beverage. And you think, wow, that'll be great. And then you taste it, and it's just not what you expected. Because that would appeal to me, Black Cherry.
Can't beat it for the price.
Oh, yeah, it's cheap.
It's like 85 cents at Sauter's.
No kidding. Huh. Sausage Joe.
Drinking coffee out of my Hobo Codes mug.
Black?
Black.
What kind? Out of the Keurig? What's the brand? Yeah,
this is, it's the donut shop. There.
Yes.
Now, speaking of the donut shop and black coffee, I went to the Dunk the other day, so I was out and about, and I ordered I pulled up to the thing there, and they asked me what I'd like, and I said I'd like a small coffee, black. I said, just like that, small coffee, black. Okay, pull around. I did. I got my coffee. It was small, and it was coffee.
It was white, wasn't it?
It was as white as can be. It was like there was so much cream and so much sugar in it. It made me sick, but I still drank it. I drank it all and had a stomachache. But, I mean, how do you mess up small black?
How much do they charge you for a small coffee, like 25 cents?
That was the thing. That's when I noticed something was up, when he asked me for like $1.70, and I was like, well, what's happening here? That seems a little much. Should be like $1 max. Then I handed it to him, and he handed me back some confection.
And you drove away and then looked at it and realized you'd been had.
I had been had. After carefully navigating my way out of that precarious driveway.
I, for one, tonight am drinking a large coffee with cream and one sugar from the Dunk.
Yeah. I run the job. Look at you.
Is that Mysterious Taco Girl?
Mysterious Taco Girl. Unreal.
Yeah. You really should subscribe. If you like listening in, because we'll hit you up all over the place. on YouTube. Subscribe to fingerlakes1.com or FL1 videos. You can hit us up on iTunes. Rate and review our podcast. That'd be a big help if you rate and review. We're on Stitcher.com. We're on Twitter and Facebook, too.
Yep.
But who isn't these days? You can go right to thesaucepod.com. Subscribe to our RSS feed. Watch or listen on your computer, tablet, phone, or TV. And now available in both the iTunes and the Google Play stores, the fingerlakes1.com app, where you can enjoy all the fingerlakes1.tv programming, including the Sauce Pod, live or on demand.
Get it.
At a later time. Mm-hmm. So I was sitting at home, or I got home Friday night. I was meeting my wife and some friends, and we were going to go grab a quick bite to eat at La Fiesta Brava.
Good choice.
And I get home, and everybody's in the kitchen, and I'm talking to them all, and all of a sudden somebody says, hey, think Zach's ready to go? And I said, Zach's here. And they're like, yeah, he's over there laying down on the couch. And then up from behind the couch pops Zach Supernova.
Oh, my goodness.
He was friend of the sleeping show? On the couch. I didn't even see him there.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes, friend of the show, Zach Supernova. Two-time guest.
Yeah.
Two-time guest. So that was quite a surprise.
He was in town for a wedding.
And then he needed a Band-Aid, and then he got in the car, and I never saw him again.
He was at your house?
Yes, he was at my because his sister was there. My wife, she was the matron of honor at our wedding for my wife. I didn't have a mate.
So why was Zach there?
Just to, he was in town. He was hanging out.
And they all needed a band. Here we had Band-Aids.
He needed a band. He wanted to get bit by Mr. Tucker Burns again.
Yeah.
Oh no, Tucker!
My dog once bit old Zach Supernova
right in the inner thigh.
Right in the juiciest part of old Zach Supernova's inside leg.
That was great.
That was ten.
You shrieked.
That was an area that had never been damaged by the sun or
no.
And took a nice big bite out of it, ripped his pants.
He cornered him.
Zach Supernova shrieked like a girl.
Tucker cornered him. He had to be rescued. Oh, my goodness. That was like 10 years ago.
That was a long time ago. That was in our old house.
That was so great.
I remember, too, that one thing about that really impressed me with Zach Supernova is not 10 minutes later, they were best friends.
That's all it takes.
I mean, the blood was still fresh on Tucker Burns' teeth, and Zach Supernova was letting him lick his face.
That's how Zach gets down. A little thigh biting.
I remember that, licking faces. I spent a lot of time with Zach Supernova this weekend.
You went to a wedding, right?
I did. We had a mutual family member.
Where was the wedding?
The wedding was at the church right by my place there, the Methodist, I think it's that what that is.
Oh,
is
it was a Methodist wedding, huh?
No, I don't know really what it was. It was just a regular old wedding. It was kind of old-fashioned, actually, the service.
Was a lot of spanking going on, men spanking women?
Yeah, there was a lot of that. No, it was like, I haven't been to a wedding recently where there was as much religion. It wasn't like a mass or anything, or like a sermon, but there's just more talk of God and things. I haven't been to a wedding like that in a while. It seems like everybody's, you know, a little less devout lately.
Yeah.
And that was it was different.
It's like, let's get through the service and get to the party after. Let's get to the
Inns at Aurora, which is where we went.
Oh, now there you go. Now that must have been great.
Fine establishment.
Saturday, was it?
Yep, Saturday.
Great weather.
Beautiful. It's beautiful. You ever been to that place?
She's one of the first ones in my class to get married female-wise, right?
Well, they're going to start dropping like flies now.
How many of her friends are married?
A few.
So you're out back of the Aurora Inn.
None of us 2,000 boys got invited.
No.
You spend most of the time out back on like the back deck.
It was outside. They had a tent set up down there. It was awesome.
Top three things you put in your mouth that night.
Filet.
Okay.
Well,
fingers. Gotta be.
What else did I have there? Vodka.
Okay.
One of those. What else did I put in my mouth?
Cold medicine?
Mushroom stuffed.
It's got to be up there.
No, we're talking about top three best things.
When you're stuffed up, nice cold medicine really top the charts.
No, I tried to drink it away. I drank some beers and that wasn't working, so I just went to the hard stuff. I didn't have any. They had the soup to start. It was really good. It was like a cauliflower whip puree sort of thing, but it was really good.
So Aurora Wedding puts on a good.
Yeah, I thought
Aurora
Inn really
puts
nice.
On a good wedding.
It was nice. The filet was really good.
So Dandy, you missed a week. Came back next week without a choice, which is the hottest new segment on the show.
Hottest.
Are you prepared this week with an excruciating choice that we all must make?
I don't know if it's excruciating, but it's a choice.
All right, well, let's do it. What you got for us tonight, Dandy?
All right, this is food related. Every time you eat, you either have to use 2 tablespoons and cover your food with black pepper, no matter what you're eating.
Every time you eat, you have to do what now?
Cover your food 2 tablespoons of black pepper.
Okay, that sounds doable.
Or 2 tablespoons of diced onions. Uncooked.
I can tell you my answer right now.
Raw diced onions?
Raw diced onions.
Now keep in mind, if you're having a bowl of Cheerios, the rule applies.
Black pepper on there. Here's what I'm thinking, though, Dandy. And maybe you can say it one way or another. I'm saying I start to make all my food in massive quantities.
Oh, yeah.
And then I just put the 2 tablespoons of...
You have to put 2 tablespoons on what's in front of you. You can cook your meal however you want to cook it, but before you eat it...
Right.
So if you want to make yourself a gigantic portion, I think that most things taste the same I think anything that would go good with onions on it would go good with black pepper probably too. So I don't think, you know.
2 tablespoons though? Say you're having a steak. You have to cover that bitch 2 tablespoons of black pepper.
And how many?
I don't mind.
Diced onions?
2 tablespoons.
Same deal. Huh. I think I'm going to go with the onions.
I'm going with the onions, hands down.
I'm going with the black pepper. I don't mind black pepper.
Like
if I had a bowl of soup, sometimes I put 2 tablespoons right in the soup anyway.
Pepper's nasty.
I like pepper a lot, but...
What if it's fresh cracked?
It's gross.
I'm thinking about something like mashed potatoes. I wouldn't mind some onions in there.
I wouldn't mind some pepper either.
That's not good.
Yeah, that would ruin the whole consistency.
Yeah, I got to go with the pepper. It's small. It might not mess up the consistency, as you said. And, yeah, raw onion.
Carl's a pepper guy, too.
So what do we got? Pepper, onion. What's your choice, Dandy?
I have to go with pepper. I can't eat onions.
What did you eat for dinner?
Gas.
I had chicken and broccoli.
Did you dice 2 tablespoons of raw onion on top of it?
No. There's no onions in it.
Probably wouldn't be very good.
No, but I hate pepper.
Really? So you don't even like something
exotic
that's prepared?
I don't even use pepper.
Wow.
Ever.
I put pepper in almost everything I cook.
I put a lot of pepper on things.
Even if a recipe calls for pepper, I do not add it.
What? Do you substitute anything?
Black pepper, though? White pepper?
All pepper.
All pepper.
Crushed red pepper?
Red pepper.
Is an exception.
Okay.
I put that on just about everything.
Yeah, I was going to say, like chili peppers.
Yeah, they're different.
Yeah.
Green pepper?
No, I don't eat green peppers.
Okay.
So
they give me edge.
Old Carl in the chat room says black pepper too,
pepper
so it was 4-1. Black peppered onions.
The only thing about the onions is the breath.
And the tears.
And the gas it gives me.
Yeah. Ruined my stomach.
I don't think it gives me gas.
I'm starting to feel a
little
better.
I could eat one single tiny piece of onion. And I would just start ripping ass in here.
So you as a rule don't eat any onions.
I try not to.
What if they're cooked?
It doesn't matter.
Really? Like if they're
what about like sausage?
You don't put it in your sauce?
Yeah, with like peppers and onions
on
there.
Onions
oh, that's
in
the best.
What about shallots?
Yeah, what about shallots?
I don't know what a shallot is.
it's a milder onion.
Yeah, it's a tinier, milder onion.
I don't think I've ever had one.
You should try it. That might be a good product for you.
Good without
sometimes
onions.
They're called shallots if you watch British cooking shows.
Would it make a difference if it was garlic? 2 tablespoons of garlic or 2 tablespoons of pepper?
Or 2 tablespoons of onions.
This is Dandy's choice.
Well, we're just exploring this here. I love garlic. I put a lot of garlic in almost everything. The thing about this challenge that sucks is that, let's say you want to have a nice piece of cake.
Right.
Or you want to have a bowl of cereal or ice cream. Or
maybe we switch to pepper.
Or even like
wouldn't be bad. Pepper wouldn't be bad on ice cream.
No, it wouldn't.
But what about on a lobster tail? It would ruin it.
Onions would be worse.
They would all be bad. It would all be bad.
I think I got to change my answer. You guys just talked me out of it.
Really? Why? Because of the cake?
Ice cream? Just because
sweets.
Of the ice cream?
Just sweets in general. Anything. An apple. If I had to eat an apple, I wouldn't want an onion on it.
So that's unanimous now. A late change in the game.
Even if you want an apple, you got to put pepper on it? Oh, my goodness.
Anything you eat.
What if I want like a now and later?
Anything that goes in your mouth.
And I think the thing is, as far as pasta is concerned, I'd rather have pepper on my pasta than onions. Although I do make a good onion.
It's pepper, let's face it.
Onion pea
pasta. Pepper's the choice.
I use them both in almost everything I cook in some way or another. I made, just this weekend, I made a salad with the pears with some... couple different kinds of cheeses and black pepper was on there, and chopped shallots. I put chopped shallots on there, and it was good.
You know, there's 4 bushels in a coom. I just found that out. 4 pecks in a bushel.
You don't really. You don't hear about coom too much because that's too much to carry.
Yeah, it's a lost measurement.
All right, Dandy. Good job there with the old choice. Now, me and Dandy played some golf together this weekend. On Sunday morning, 18 holes. It was me and Mysterious Taco Girl's brother-in-law against a guy
Mysterious
I like to call
Man.
Hernando and Dandy R&D. And so anyways, we're having a good little match. Now, we gave Dandy some strokes because if you go by average score, so what we said was 1 stroke a hole for old Dandy, except for the par threes. And we had a match. It was quite a good match. It was it wasn't really back and forth. They won a hole. We won a hole. We tied a bunch of holes. Said to my partner, person that wins the next hole is going to win this match. So we got to make sure we win the next hole. So needless to say, we tie 12. We tie 13. We tie 14. Now old Dandy steps up on the 15th tee, hits one right down the middle. We're like, oh, great, with a stroke. Dandy, you lay 0 up there. But we're still thinking he's going to mess it up somehow between that there and the hole. So next thing you know, old Dandy hits a shot to about 10 feet. And I'm like, oh, man. So now he's putting for a birdie, but it really would be a 2. And my partner and I both had birdie putts. And we missed. And then Dandy knocked in his birdie.
Oh, my god! And
basically won the match for his team.
What a guy.
We won the last hole to save a little bit of face. But old Dandy really came through in the clutch.
Made me play from the men's tees.
It's not that big a difference. Your score wasn't like any higher than normal, right? You played fairly well. You wasted a lot of shots around.
I started out, first five holes, I started out great. And after that, it was not so much good.
Except for that big birdie on 15.
Got me a free lunch.
Yeah, I bought Dandy's lunch.
Wow. Big day for you.
Almost took his head off on that hole. On the next hole, too.
And we're on the 17th hole, and Dandy's short right of the green, and I was in a bunker, a greenside bunker. Now, so I'm standing on next to the bunker, nowhere near the hole, and Dandy's way far away on the right. Not way far away. It wasn't that. You probably had about a 30-yard little shot.
No, not even. I hit that thing dead left. Like, it didn't go straight whatsoever. It went dead left.
So I'm standing there. Not even watching Dandy hit, and next thing I know, I see those guys over there yell at me, you know, look out, and I couldn't, I looked up, I didn't see the ball, so I just put my head down.
No, you didn't, you held the towel over your face.
Like no, I put my face down and put my hand behind my head so I didn't get struck in the head, and the ball landed about 2 inches from me.
You want to know the worst part about that? Is I beat him on that hole.
Wow.
After that shot.
Yeah, I tipped my shot in the bunker way on the other side of the green. No, I made a 4. You didn't make a 4.
Yeah, I did.
No, then we tied. Well, you won with your stroke. Dandy's stroke.
Remember because I came out of the bunker, you were like, after you crushed yours out of the bunker almost into the woods.
Right.
You were like, let's see how you do. And I rolled it up like 5 feet away.
Did you? Well, and then you made the putt for 4.
Sounds like an exciting day out on the links.
It was a lot of fun. It's always fun doing anything.
I'm hearing about it when I'm not there.
It's
I'm jealous.
You were invited.
I wasn't in town.
Ah. Now, you can probably attest to this more than anybody, Mysterious Taco Girl, but doing anything with Dandy's fun.
Yeah.
Really unless he's in a grumpy mood, and then it's terrible.
Yeah, he usually snaps out of it, though, eventually.
I'm always grumpy.
Or maybe it's just me.
You just got to hang with him.
Snap him out of it.
You just got to hang with him.
If I'm not on the couch, I'm grumpy.
It's not true. He's lying to you, Sauce fans.
So, let's go forward now, because we got more women's issues to get to, but first...
Fantastic.
First, it's our tweet of the week. This week's tweet of the week comes from at Johnny Sun, who tweets, "The average American eats 8 spiders in their sleep every year, but the exceptional American strives to eat at least 20. Tweet of the week. They say that. I never really believe that. Do you guys think you eat 8 spiders in your sleep? And if the average American eats 8 spiders in their sleep every year, you can bet that you've eaten an average of about 8 spiders.
No, I think that is a...
You've eaten spiders, let's put it that way, more than you think.
It's a lie.
Yeah, but that's not true. I mean, the average person doesn't eat that many spiders.
Well, that's true. Johnny's son is just saying it. I don't really, never really verified it.
I think it's a common wives' tale.
I'm a known mouth closed sleep kind of guy.
Yeah.
You're known for it?
Yeah. Except for last week when I was sick and I had to be a mouth breather.
You ate.
I felt like the biggest scumbag. All your spiders
that week.
All week last week. Just walking around.
Oh, I hate that. I don't want to get sick from you guys.
Speaking of sick, this microphone smells disgusting.
Really?
Oh, I wonder why. There was a Demolition Derby podcast prior to the show tonight.
It looks probably like somebody was there chewing on the front of it.
Well, that would be Tito from the Chew Gum podcast. He gnaws on it in show all the time. Got some more tweets here, actually. They didn't quite make the cut, but I got another one here from Johnny Sun. He was our tweeter of the week. He says, actually, the children's story, The Three Little Pigs, is the first documented report of a wolf who can breathe hurricanes. Think about it.
Wow.
Take that for granted. He would blow the house down. You know how much wind speed is needed to blow a house down? He blew a house down made of straw, which is an impressive feat for a wolf.
Yeah.
Then he blew a house down made of sticks.
And then?
Then he, the brick house stood. So the story goes. At Abby has issues tweets. I heard Google is turning 15 years old today. Now it's really going to think it knows everything. A jab at adolescents who think they know everything.
Shout out to the Google Doodle that day.
Oh, yeah? What did they do? I don't remember seeing that.
It was like a birthday party pinata smacking game.
I actually played that. Yeah. I know, and it's funny that you would say that, and I wouldn't remember it. And then when you said I actually did, I hit the pinata.
I got 159.
I think 130-something was my highest.
Yeah, bummed I missed really it.
Worked it wasn't really that great, but... At Cloud Rivers tweets, if you say Starbucks in the mirror 3 times, a girl in yoga pants will appear, steal your hoodie, and tell you the best things about fall.
It's a funny one.
That is comical.
At Schieber tweets, people say drugs are bad, but I'm calling complete BS on that. I've only been on meth for 20 minutes, and I'm already the king of Jupiter. Not really the king of Jupiter. He just thinks he is because he's on meth.
Yeah.
Speaking of meth, did you guys watch the Breaking Bad finale yet?
No, I'm going to watch it when I get home.
Oh, well, see, I'm still in season 4. I just couldn't get caught up in time because my sleepy wife always falling asleep when I got a good 2 hours left in me of Breaking Bad watching. You add that up over a course of several weeks and I would have been caught up. You watch that show, Dandy?
No.
How about you, Mysterious Taco Girl?
Negative.
And we know Saucy Joe does. It's a good show. It's certainly something I'd recommend. It is a solid show through the first 2.5 seasons, and then it really starts to pick up, and it becomes a great show. And who knows about season 5 for old Tony sometimes, because I haven't watched it yet.
Do we have a breaking news sound clip?
Do we have a breaking news sound clip? Sure. You got breaking news?
I do.
Okay.
You better play it quick.
Baby, you got a stew going.
Breaking news. Danny R&D reporting live from the FingerLakes1.com studios.
I got this on Twitter from our good friend Rudy P. Ringtone. Curiosity rover finds water on Mars.
No way.
What?
No.
Yep.
How is that? Did you click through to the story?
No, but I heard the story. They didn't find water. They found... What's the word I'm looking for?
Water? Aqua?
They didn't find water per se.
They
but
found the components of water?
There you go.
Hydrogen and two oxygens?
Not components. Not even
or two hydrogens and one oxygen?
Right.
Give me 15 minutes and I'll come back to you. And I'm like, I got it now.
Okay.
There's one word I'm looking for and I can't say it. They found...
Boy, you got 15 minutes.
Ice?
No.
Evidence?
Matt? There you go. Evidence.
Really?
Of water.
That's what you're going for?
Oh, well, they had that before when they found those like dried up creek beds or whatever early on in the thing.
Are you looking at Rudy's timeline from 2011?
No, he just posted it to me 2 days ago, 3 days ago.
I think
he attached me to it, so I would know.
Oh, I see.
Because he knows you hate the Mars rover.
Yeah. Good old Rudy.
Yeah, but then I went and I read about it, and they found evidence. I don't think a ditch is evidence of water.
No, not necessarily. But if that ditch has it moves, it's formed in a way that only water flowing like downhill could make.
But now I think they have hard evidence.
Concrete evidence.
Huh. Well, this comes kind of off the heels of a recent announcement that they didn't think that there was life on Mars. Like a weekend or two ago, they said something like, you know, they didn't think there was.
Unfortunately, 98% of NASA's employees will be out of work tomorrow, so.
I've been thinking about it. I think I would want to be the first person to go to Mars.
You would want to be?
Yeah, just me by myself.
Oh, that'd be...
Can you imagine, Dandy, what that entails? The training and the... There's no way you would ever make it.
And then just once you go...
Give me some meth from that show Breaking Bad.
Right.
Send me to fucking Mars.
Yeah, but that's fake meth, so that'd be even worse. That's like movie meth. You don't really get high off it.
Because you know the first guy that goes there, you're not coming back. Whoever you are goes to Mars, that's it.
Absolutely not.
You're signing your certificate of death.
You're going to be buried on Mars.
So I would like to be that guy by myself. Maybe my dog, too. I mean, dog.
You're signing your dog's death certificate.
He's going to die someday anyways.
It's true. Might as well die on Mars with no dog food or any...
We'd be famous.
You would
certainly
famous.
Would be.
Well,
you would be
infamous. Very famous.
If there's probably. One thing you'd be, it's famous. If you were the first man on Mars,
first
no doubt about
first
it.
First two to Mars,
forever.
Me and Kingston.
Yeah.
Oh, Dan Aaron D and his faithful dog Kingston, the first people on Mars.
What would make it even better is if they thought we died and then sent a new guy to Mars.
And you were there.
We met him
with a huge long beard.
And your, dog bit him in the inside of his thigh.
In a cup of water.
The first thing that would happen would be that Kingston would probably shit in the rover.
Oh, most definitely.
Yeah.
He'd probably shit on me in the rover.
Now, you realize there's no gravity, so it's not going to, like, sit on the floor. It's going
to,
like...
I'll hang on to him. He's heavy.
No, the crap is going to go all over the place, and it doesn't matter how heavy he is if there's no gravity.
Well, no, there is gravity. It's just different gravity.
Well, that fecal matter will be floating around the module. Yeah. Inside, and
is there gravity on
Danny
Mars?
Danny would be instantly. Yeah. They would blast him off. He'd be about 10 minutes into the trip after he breaks out of our orbit, and his dog would take a crap, and there'd be fecal matter. And
I
he would immediately regret his decision.
I bet you he would shit before we let the before we left the atmosphere.
And they'd have to call off the launch. What we're talking about is kind of ridiculous.
A little bit.
I don't see you being the first man on Mars, Danny. I mean, anything can happen. I mean, anything.
Wouldn't you rather send me than, like, a smart scientist?
No, because number one, I'd never get to see you again. Number two,
that was cute.
You wouldn't be able to do any good for mankind at all. Like, a smart scientist?
Yeah, but you send the smart scientist up there, then you lose him. He's gone.
Yeah, but he's not at work. He's reporting back. I mean, there's.
I can report back.
There's benefits.
Yeah, but can you find two hydrogens and one oxygen?
So the gravity of Mars is 3.711 meters per second squared, which is here it's 9.8 meters per second squared. So it's less than half.
So I'd be able to jump like a basketball player.
Yes, much more actually.
Then Danny would spend his whole time dunking.
I'd want a 12-foot basketball hoop to be sent with me that I could erect when I get there. And that's all I would do, play one-on-one against the dog.
Worst scientific mission ever.
Yeah, it's been the
same. We're not going for science. We're going for fun.
Obviously.
The first guy usually doesn't go for fun. That's usually like the 400th guy. It's like the first guy to go to America is... Or like Christopher Columbus or America's Vespucci or Leif Erikson, whoever the heck the first guy was, didn't come for fun. But
he had fun when he got here.
Several hundreds or thousands of people later, they started coming for fun. The Titanic is an example of people who came for fun.
They weren't coming here.
They were coming here for fun in the Titanic.
Really? The Titanic was like coming into the United States.
It left Europe to come here to the U.S. It was supposed to dock in New York, wasn't it?
That's for a fun, stupid vacation. Who would leave Europe to come here? Europeans, obviously.
Yeah.
That's dumb.
Well, we got some news this week, and I think we best report these important stories. Dandy Aaron, do your diesel cigarette for the first time tonight. That's our news.
Breaking news.
Breaking news.
We're like almost an hour in. That's good for me.
Yeah, that's solid. You're usually two a show. Well, I got some news here from Scott Township, Pennsylvania. Penis-shaped pillars arouse controversy in Pennsylvania town.
Dang.
Citizens of Scott Township, Pennsylvania, are in a nutty battle over a set of concrete pillars. This is from the Huffington Post, and they always throw in the little wordplay.
Yep.
They're in a nutty battle over a set of concrete pillars that some people feel look like concrete penises. The pillars, actually bollards, were recently erected to keep traffic from driving into nearby structures. Four were installed at a bus stop near a church, while six others were arrayed across the street, according to Philly.com. You want to see a picture of these things so we know what we're talking about?
Yeah, sure.
Here are the bollards that were installed in Clarktown Township, Pennsylvania. And when I look at those, immediately I think erect concrete penis.
It looks like a chapstick to me.
Yeah, but it looks like all the other
bollards you've ever seen.
It looks more like perhaps like a bullet.
It looks like the thing that they needed to do the job. They needed, they were erected. They were erected to stop people from driving through a certain area.
Mr. Stocko Grill is tweaking and massaging that penis.
I can't get it.
No, that image is too wide.
That's ridiculous. That sounds like something you'd see on like Parks and Recreation. Like that's the kind of crazy bullshit that people like that think of.
It is, and there the bollards are at a distance. With people walking by him.
God, I can't look at him. It's so terrible.
It's,
what's wrong with people?
It's really, really stupid. And the fact that this would even make it onto our radar as a news story is pretty disappointing.
Well, we're not above that here at the Sauce Pod, so.
According to Pat Martin, people are laughing at it. They're calling it Penis Road.
Oh, boy.
She told the township commissioners Tuesday. One commissioner, Eileen Meyer, said she didn't see the bollards before they were ordered and concluded that she would have preferred something more antique to something and a little something less penis. That's pretty stupid. Dandy, if you were the mayor of Scott Township, Pennsylvania, what would you do to solve this situation?
Everybody that thought they looked like penises, I would kick them. I would ban them from town.
Wow. That might be
because that's a fucking idiotic statement.
It is.
That's almost as bad as when they freaked out. Remember the scratch-offs or the lottery tickets that those people freaked out about?
Oh, that looked like because they had sex something sexual on them.
Yeah.
Looked like penises. Anything looks like a penis.
It's stupid. That's just somebody that has nothing better to do than to find something to bitch about. Like that crazy bitch that sits on the corner of Burned Dairy. She'd be that lady.
Yes. Every town has one. There. Yeah, surrounded by bollards. Thing is, you see, like Mysterious Tower Girl says, you see those things around all the time.
Yeah, they're everywhere.
So now my question is, if they didn't have the little dome top.
The ridge, the rim, just, what do they call it?
If it was just straight, would you have walked up and been like, oh my God, an uncircumcised penis? Like,
nope.
I know this. Let's get out of this town right away, honey. It's full of concrete penises.
We have to get out of here. That's stupid.
I definitely thought when you showed the picture it was going to look more like a penis than...
Yeah. And less like a bollard.
Yeah.
Would you say you were let down?
I was very disappointed.
Yeah. I'm looking at pictures of bollards, just random pictures of bollards on Google.
And how many of them look like a penis?
They all look that way.
Can you show us any of
them? You know, I'm like this one here. This one looks more like... This one's got, you know, it's got lighting at the top.
Oh yeah!
Oh no!
I saw it quick enough. Ribbed. Yeah. It was ribbed.
That looks like a man with a old timey war helmet on.
Got a World War One helmet on.
It's disrespectful to veterans.
Yeah.
Goddamn penises with World War One helmets on them.
Damn it!
So they proposed, anyways, with these bollards to shave the top so it's flat, but that creates another controversy that becomes a little dangerous because there's a sharp edge on it. Yeah. So. Really, nobody can win in this non-issue in Scott Township, Pennsylvania.
What a boring place.
Dateline. Saudi Arabia. Saudi clerk says women who drive risk damaging their ovaries.
Dang.
A conservative Saudi Arabian cleric has said women who drive risk damaging their ovaries and bearing children with clinical problems, counteracting activists who are trying to end the Islamic Kingdom's male-only driving rules.
This is because women aren't allowed to drive.
Yeah, we shouldn't be.
In Saudi Arabia. So you're okay with this one too, huh, Mr. Yep. You are quite the advocate for the modern women.
I mean, the same could be said for men.
Yeah. Except for the part about the ovaries and bearing male-formed children.
A campaign calling for women to defy the ban in a protest drive on October 26th has spread rapidly online over the past week and gained support from prominent women activists. On Sunday, the campaign's website was blocked inside the kingdom. That's how they do things in Saudi Arabia. They perform in a protest, so they block the group's website.
Yeah, that's just how it is.
This is highly suspect. In an interview published on Friday on the website sabq.org, Sheikh Saleh bin Saad al-Lohaden said women aiming to overturn the ban on driving should put reason ahead of their hearts, emotions, and passions.
Yeah.
Think this one out, ladies. You can't drive a car. I know you want to.
We can't have women out driving around getting aroused over every bollard that they see in Saudi Arabia.
Be reasonable about it.
Yeah.
Reuters early wrongly identified him as Sheikh Saleh bin Muhammad al-Lohaden, a member of the Senior Council of Scholars, which, easy mistake to make there.
Clearly.
By contrast, Sheikh Saleh bin Saad al-Lohaden, the person quoted in the report, is a judicial advisor to an association of golf psychologists. He says, if a woman drives a car not out of pure necessity, that could have negative physiological impacts, as functional and physiological medical studies show that it automatically affects the ovaries and pushes the pelvic upward.
No studies show that. Zero studies.
No, he didn't cite any
studies.
No
one's ever
either.
Studied that, actually.
No.
No one's actually ever even done a study.
If you're a Saudi cleric, you can just say things.
Yeah.
Don't you wish you lived somewhere where you could just spout off anything?
Dandy could get away as being a Saudi cleric.
They do that here. I mean, people spout off stuff like that all the time here. There's never been a study on that, ever, by anyone. I'm starting to feel sick again. I'm getting a little worked up.
Over the way women are treated in Saudi Arabia.
No, over the way that my sinuses are being treated by my own body.
So they don't have a specific law that bans women from driving, but only men are granted driver's licenses, so that's the way they get around that.
Yeah.
Dandy, would you support a ban on female drivers here in the U.S.?
all female drivers?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the way it works.
If you have ovaries, you are not allowed to drive a car.
That includes golf carts.
Oh, yeah, there's a little Dandy's Choice twist to it all.
I wouldn't ban all women drivers, just women drivers over the age of 62.
The politically correct answer would have been no. But you were going to go with drivers over 62, women under or over 62?
Over. I would ban males over 62 also, though, if that makes it any better.
Someday you'll be 62 and you're going to want to go to the store.
I'm not going to be 62.
And you're going to regret that stance.
I'm not going to make it to 62.
Well, we'll see.
I'm shooting for around 57.
Well, that raises another interesting question. Shouldn't Saudi women over childbearing age be able to drive?
Once they've gone through menopause.
Since they don't have to worry about their ovaries.
They don't have menopause in Saudi Arabia.
I didn't know that.
They did a study on it.
Yeah.
A medical study.
Danny did a study.
I studied it.
If they don't have any fear of damaging their ovaries anymore, because who really cares if you can't bear children? They should be allowed to drive. I want to debate this guy.
The other thing about it, if this was an argument here in America, just showing different cultures, the argument would be based around we should let them drive because of the economic impact it would have. You'd sell more gas, you'd sell more cars, women would be able to get to stores and buy more.
Sure.
But in Saudi Arabia, that's not an issue because they're just sitting on piles of gold.
You know who makes laws like that? People with small penises.
Yeah. Bollard envy. That's what that is.
Got to make themselves feel better about only being able to drive. So it makes up for them having a tiny, tiny, tiny
penis. Wouldn't sell a single VW Beetle if women couldn't drive. They'd just get rid of it.
I bet you they have not one Subaru in Saudi Arabia.
Right.
It's not one.
No.
Now,
be gone.
There's one thing I learned tonight. It's that mysterious taco girl wishes she lived in 1950 in Saudi Arabia.
I don't feel like she's even here tonight.
Well, she's like playing a game, or she must have a high score like
she's
going.
She's just kind of...
Oh, she just shut it down.
Giving in. Because usually a comment about women being spanked, you would really get up in arms over.
Yeah, no, not tonight.
Interesting.
I'm the only one who's able to come here and not participate. Not you.
Who said?
That's Danny's job.
That's my job.
Yeah, but you're participating, so someone's got
to... Women have to participate, says Danny.
I'm all hopped up on NyQuil.
Mm.
That's my drug of choice when I got a cold. Soda. I'll drink it during the day.
Yeah?
I've been killing DayQuil and NyQuil.
I don't like DayQuil.
And some Airborne.
I have a hard time getting off the NyQuil.
I take sometimes a triple dose before bed. I don't measure it out. I just gulp it from the jar.
Every medication I take, I double it.
Right.
Now, I really want to get it.
Now, on the American Life podcast, or this American Life podcast, they did an episode recently, which was about Tylenol, acetaminophen. If you take double the dose of acetaminophen, you could die. In fact, they've found that a small percentage of people, but a significant percentage, that took double the dose of acetaminophen, some had died, some had liver damage.
Sure. It's highly
That's why I'm only going to make it to 57, because when I get a headache, a real bad one, I take four Advils.
Yeah, well, Advil's different, though.
Well, sure, people...
It's acetaminophen. Little.
We'll always take more than the recommended doses. That's what's scary about it, about the fact of the acetaminophen.
Or Tylenol, whatever I got in the cupboard.
Tylenol's worse for you than Advil.
I double it. Screw that, too. That two stuff's for kids.
No, it's BS, because if you take Advil, like if you take doctor-prescribed Advil, it's 8 regular Advil. It's 800 milligrams.
A day?
No. Whenever you want.
Well, I don't know.
Like every four hours.
Does Advil have acetaminophen in it?
No.
No. We'll say Tylenol just for...
Well, it is the podcast focused on Tylenol.
They're different.
I buy whatever it's on sale. Tylenol, Advil, that all does the same.
One works better, I think.
Not when you take four. They all work the same.
I think they have different efficacies on different people.
Yeah, I think different people, they work better for.
Well, unless anybody else has any more breaking news, that's all the news I got tonight that's fit to report.
We got nothing.
I got. Do we do what I learned still? You
got a stew. Sure is. Did he send us one in?
Yeah, it's just a poly always. All right, never mind. Yeah, I learned something this weekend.
What did you learn?
I learned that people who grow up in Hawaii, all they want to do is get off of the island.
Really?
How'd you learn that?
That's what this
documentary
person told me.
You know someone from Hawaii? Or is this another piece of advice from Rudy P. Ringo?
No. I was talking to somebody about it this weekend. All, like, us people want to do is go to Hawaii.
I don't want
to
go.
All people that grow up in Hawaii just want to leave Hawaii.
It's a small, isolated place. They've been there. Yeah. They want to get out.
I never realized that.
I think it's also pretty common of most places. People want to leave and go somewhere else.
Grass is always greener, sometimes just in their nature. Some people, I bet you there's also people that lived in Hawaii that never want to leave.
People that like internet and stuff like that.
They don't have the internet in Hawaii?
Well, they do, but not good like us.
All right, we got it good here on the mainland.
I bet they got it pretty concerts. Good.
Well, they
people say you really like a band. You might be able to see them, once every 2 years.
Depends
on
who the band is. If your favorite artist in the world is Jimmy Buffett, you're fucking loving it over in Hawaii. That guy's over there all the time.
Or Don Ho, if you're a big Don Ho fan.
Or if you like ukulele music, you're killing it. It's time of your life.
I thought that was weird. I never thought of it like that before.
That is interesting, Danny. Very interesting.
The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake, Danny.
You want to know why the grass is greener on the other side?
No. Yeah, I
that's do. Where the shit pipes run.
That's where the shit pipes run.
Remember that.
Okay.
Well, moving right along, coming up just past the 1 hour mark of the podcast. Time to find out what everybody recommends up here tonight. Dandy, what do you recommend tonight?
I recommend watching all the new TV shows that have just started on the cable channels.
Such as?
Homeland, Eastbound and Down, Boardwalk Empire, and I haven't watched the other one that Survivor started.
What one?
That's not cable.
Parks and Rec?
No, it's the sex show on.
Masters of Sex.
I haven't watched it. I taped it.
I have it too. I gotta go watch it.
I have a sneaky suspicion that show is gonna suck.
Or it's going to be awesome, which is what I think.
Really?
Yep. I wouldn't say it if I didn't mean it.
I hope it's good.
Yeah, I think it is.
Mysterious Taco Girl, got a recommendation.
No, skip me.
Okay, we'll come back.
Whoa.
Saucy Joe. All
right. I recommend that everybody go out and do some research and get ready for the new Valve Steam Box that's coming out, which is a little, I guess you consider it a micro console coming out, allows you to use, I don't know if anyone here is familiar with the Steam service, but it's a video game delivery service that's been around for a long time, made by Valve. And
it's like Netflix for video games?
No.
That's Gamefly.
Yeah, that's Gamefly.
It's like iTunes for video games?
Yeah, more like iTunes for video games. But they're making their own console and hardware. It's coming out. It's going to be awesome.
What's going to make it awesome?
Basically, it will use your Steam library on your computer and stream it, the gameplay, to your TV. So you'll now be able to play PC games on your television from your PC in real time streaming. Pretty awesome stuff.
What kind of games?
Any game.
Madden?
If it's on Steam.
Well, that's what I'm saying. What games are on Steam?
Most everything.
But not EA Sports games?
Who plays Madden? No,
I mean, those are mostly
the computer anyways.
You know, those are mostly licensed to Xbox and PlayStation.
Not many people play Madden on computer or sports games, but ones that do are generally people like to customize it. And you can usually customize it, your experience on a PC more than on a console. Like change uniforms and whatnot, or I don't know. Or you can hack it. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'll tell you though, I do recommend this week. You're getting ready, sit down, watch some TV. You and your old lady, or whatever have you, and you need to bring over a snack. Well, why not throw together a quick cheese tray?
Why not?
I mean, you take like a big platter.
How could I not come up with that on the fly?
You get yourself some, you go to the fridge and you get yourself a block of cheese, cut off some slices, or maybe you buy it pre-cube sliced. Cheese is not a hard thing to find. So when you pick up some sharp cheddar, you pick up some pecorino, whatever, any type of cheese you want. Keep your fridge stocked with cheese. And then what you do is you get some crackers, throw a little spicy mustard in a pile on the plate, throw a little grape jelly, raspberry jelly on the plate, throw a couple grapes, throw some strawberries. You can basically throw anything you want on a cheese tray, but the trick is to keep it cheesy, keep it crunchy, and keep it sweet. You need those three elements. A little spice doesn't hurt, too. It's easy to do, and instead of feeling like a trailer park dirtbag eating Doritos out of a bag, you're going to feel like a Saudi Arabian prince spanking your women while eating crackers and cheese.
It'd be incredible.
Like a real high roller.
Yeah.
So
I dated a girl who, when she wanted a television snack, would make a batch of French fries, and then she would get every condiment you could possibly put on French fries and arrange them on a tray. Ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise,
relish, barbecue sauce,
all of it. And then she would just have a dipping party.
Yeah, I loved condiments. I loved to dip, and the cheese tray plays into that.
She also used to put sugar on her pizza.
I don't make cheese trays.
Probably because you're like, this is a lot of work to make a cheese tray, yeah, but you know it's not. I do? It's super easy.
You know what I do? I open, like I
you open the fridge and stuff your mouth with cheese.
I buy
six bites out of the bricks.
Buy
of
the
cheese.
Bricks of cheese, and I just sit there and eat it like it's
like
an
a
apple.
Candy bar.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now I saw a picture on the internet on Imgur or whatever. What's the name of that site?
Imgur.
Imgur.
Yeah.
And it was a like a
I can find
400 pound
lady for you
lady.
Right now.
Sitting on a like a motorized scooter in a crowd of people eating a block of cheese like it was an apple.
I just
a big block. It was like a huge block of cheese.
It's my neighbor. Have you ever? She's over in our neighborhood all the time.
She eats cheese?
Well, the thing about it is
on a scooter.
The thing about that picture is that you can't even see it in this version, but she has a box of yes, you can.
She's got a
box of Cheez-Its. In the back of her scooter.
For when she's done with her 17-pound block of cheese that she's eating like a watermelon.
Oh, now that's a bigger block than I usually eat.
See where that black arrow is pointing? To a box of Cheez-Its in the back there.
Dandy, man or woman?
No, that's a woman.
That's a woman. Okay. While I have this up here, here's the new Steambox controller just so you can see what it is. They don't have those little toggle-y game controller sticks there. That is haptic feedback. Little touch pads, two of them, and a touch screen in the middle, in case you're wondering how that's going to feel. Different. different.
It would. No buttons.
More like an iPod.
Where's the A button? Where's the square
the a button
triangle
is right,
button?
Right here. The A button is right there.
Oh, so there's a couple buttons.
Yeah, there's buttons there.
I would like to say that I don't think there's anybody on this earth that eats more cheese than me.
There's definitely
you haven't met my friend Frank Camilleri.
I bet you I could eat it, beat him in a cheese off.
I would love to see it.
So you eat cheese and that doesn't give you gas, but
are you telling me that you eat more cheese than this woman?
I mean, give I me never have, but I could.
Are you sure that's a woman?
I could.
Wait a minute.
That's why I was wondering myself.
Look at that face. That's a woman.
Look at her. Get down on that cheese.
That is awful.
She's not ashamed.
And she's wearing a fucking dress.
Look at that.
And she's got a couple of heart emblems on her.
I definitely eat more cheese than her. Maybe not in one sitting, but over a lifetime, I guess.
Well, here's the thing. All she does is sit. It's one long sitting, this woman. She's never stood up in 20 years.
She was like going to the park, and she's like, I got to bring some cheese. Most people might fill a Ziploc baggie with a few cubes. She brings a block.
Yeah.
I love cheese. I get me all pumped
you
up.
You think you could eat that much cheese, that whole block of cheese that she had that was legitimately a 5-pound block?
Not that cheap government cheese that she's eating, but I can eat some cheese.
You eat fancy cheese by the bushel.
I can eat some cheese.
By the coom.
Carl's got a recommendation.
Oh, yeah?
What were you going to ask?
Well, what's Carl's recommendation?
Spanking your significant other.
He's not going by sex there, male or female. Uh-huh. It could be either one, right? He's not demeaning women. He would like to be spanked by his spouse.
Yep.
I was actually going to say, Dandy, do you like fondue?
Like,
do you ever have a fondue cheese party? Well, I'm not talking just melt some cheese in the microwave. I'm saying fondue with the pot, with the sticks that you dip in different things into the cheese.
Gang of good company. See, hanging around, dipping cheese.
I mean, I would. If I came to your house and you had a nice fondue going, I'd eat it.
I thought you loved cheese.
Yeah, I love cheese. So I'm more about the cheese than the dipping the shit into the cheese.
You just want just straight cheese?
Yeah.
The block cheese. Regular salad cheese is a much better delivery system than melted cheese. Because then you have to use something else to deliver it.
So a perfect cheese tray to you would be just cheese? Just no crackers?
You know what I like on there? Grapes. Cheese.
Pepperoni.
I like grapes on my cheese.
I'll even
tray.
Buy like shredded cheese that come in the bags.
Yeah. You and squeeze it together.
Stick my hand in there and just squeeze it together and eat.
Let
like
your
a ball.
Sweat bond it.
Exactly the same eating habits as my 5-year-old son, baby. It's amazing. That is amazing.
You can't tell me it's not a great idea.
No, it is. I've done it.
It's so good.
He learned it by watching me, all right.
Like you get the old five cheese blend.
I don't like the 5 cheese blend.
No?
No.
Are you talking about Sargento? Are you talking about Sargento?
You can't go cheap with it. You gotta get a Sargento or a Kraft.
None
you can't
of
get
that,
like the store brand IGA or freaking Tops.
None of that shredded cheese in bags is any good. And you ask me, if you want to have a cheese experience, whether you're making nachos in the fridge or in the oven, or you're making a cheese tray, or you're shredding cheese for some purpose, you gotta get it off the block. That shredded stuff is not that good, even for pizza.
You can shred it yourself at home.
Yeah, that's what I do for the most part.
Cuisinart or by hand?
By hand.
By hand.
Because I usually don't ever need that much.
It's the only way you have to run the real risk of shredding your knuckles, and that's what a what
real man
is all about. Do you have a recommendation yet?
I know how much you guys love when I recommend other podcasts, so I'm going to recommend...
We do love it. We can't get too enough of it.
Here's the Thing with Alec Baldwin.
Dang.
Okay, Alec Baldwin has a podcast.
And he interviews a wide range of people, and I find it to be very interesting.
I'm sure it is, because Alec Baldwin's a funny guy to listen to.
Did he?
It's not that funny.
It isn't?
No.
It's disappointing.
Did he tell the story about how he just slapped the shit out of a photographer?
No, it's pretty serious.
Again?
And I think it's cool because he does get such a bad rap, but I find him to be very interesting.
I do too. Did you see this week's South Park?
No.
Yeah, Alec Baldwin was in that episode as well.
Against his will.
Actually, it was Bill Hader as the voice of Alec Baldwin, but he was portrayed. And if you're an Alec Baldwin fan, you might enjoy that episode.
I just like that he smacks the shit out of people all the time.
You got to think it's
coming.
I probably
would too.
If you're one of those photographers, you got to expect it once in a while.
Did you see the new law?
No.
In Los Angeles?
No.
It passed?
Yeah, they can now get arrested for taking pictures of
children.
Yeah,
that makes sense. Good for them.
It's only fair. I mean, come on.
6 months in jail? Or oh, like, my. I forget what the money was. A couple $100, I think.
I'd pay the couple $100.
Sure.
Over the 6 months in jail?
That's like your whole paycheck is a fucking paparazzi, though.
No, not
unless
necessarily.
Unless you're getting that one picture
that they're paying
a lot
for.
Of money for,
yeah,
you're getting minimum wage.
You know what the pictures they're paying
well, they're not
money
getting
for
anything because they're freelancers.
So they like TMZ has a whole...
Now, I bet you they employ freelancers. All those crazy paparazzi that follow these people around are trying to get the shot. And then once they get it, they go to TMZ and say, I got this shot.
No, TMZ, if you watch that show, all those people that are on the show are at the actual...
Well, they're editors. I don't know if they're photographers.
Most of them are. They don't do freelance. I think the bigger companies are more.
It seems like it would
be
impossible.
People, like the Post hire someone.
Yeah.
It would be impossible, though, to. It doesn't seem economically feasible to pay one person to track. You know, if you have a staff of, let's say, even you have a staff of 20 photographers, how can you cover all this?
If you have a website, you're advertising.
Well, no, I understand. He's
saying the manpower to cover that area geographically.
There's like 100
people. It's hard.
100 stars.
So they have like freelancers. It's they got 1,000 people out there taking pictures, and whoever gets it in gets it in.
We'll have to get Harvey Levin on from TMZ and ask him how he does it.
We should
work on that, Andy. Maybe next week.
I'll get a hold of him.
Maybe next week.
I'll talk to him when we're at the gym next time.
What's a soft cheese? It has a skin on it, but Brie. It's very soft. Brie. You like Brie, Andy?
Love Brie.
I like Brie, too.
Big fan of goat cheese.
See, now there's a cheese that you're going to want to get sort of melty anyway. Brie's, you got to get it a little soft, heated up.
I'll still bite it.
I'm just saying.
Do you eat the rind as well with Brie?
You don't want to eat that part.
No.
Well, I'm just not sure what Dandy does.
Not even Dandy's that crazy about cheese.
Well, we've done it again. Another Monday night up here. Any parting shots before we say goodnight to September? Wake up tomorrow. It's going to be October.
Wake me up when September ends.
Tomorrow's October?
Yesterday was the last day of the month.
I'm talking about government shutdowns.
Got 2.5 hours left in September. Enjoy it. Eat some cheese.
Obamacare.
I threw that letter away.
These things are happening.
All these things and more will happen in October. And we'll be back on what? It'll be October 6th? Yeah, it'll be October 7th. Monday, October 7th. Yep. We'll be back. Until then, America, keep it cheesy.